Ladies and gentlemen, wonderful people, this is Call of Duty Fanatics. Welcome back to another Call of Duty report. All right, we are gonna dive into this straight away without any delay and no nonsense talk. Today, we are talking about something that's been on everyone's mind, but no one wants to admit. Call of Duty has one of the most toxic communities in gaming history. And it's not by accident. Activision has strategically cultivated this mess for years, building an army of fanboys and bots to defend their shady business practices at all cost. And if you ever had the misfortune of arguing with a COD fanboy online, you know exactly what I mean.
Dude, they're doing everything right, bro. They're listening to the community this time, dude. Dude, I'm telling you, bro. I'm telling you, bro. Brand new COD, this is the one, bro. They know what they're doing, man. They've learned from their mistakes.
And to set the record straight, guys, when I say Call of Duty fanboy, I'm not talking about the OGs and the hardcore fans. I'm not talking about casuals, definitely. And I'm definitely not talking about reasonable people playing this game. What I'm talking about here is the army of obnoxious pieces of shit.
Are you serious?
That are flooding this game for the last year or two. So people who just recently started playing this game and they already know everything. They know about history, they know about the lore, they know about the stories, they know what's good, what's bad, they know absolutely everything. That's the type of people I'm talking about. It all starts with how Call of Duty has been marketed over the years. Call of Duty isn't just a game. Activision turned it into a lifestyle. They pump millions of dollars into advertisements, events, and collaborations that make people feel like they need to be part of this community. And at first, that sounds great, right? You want people to love the game and feel connected. But what happens when that connection turns into blind loyalty?
Yeah, they're doing it. Hey, they're doing everything right, bro. They're doing everything right this time, dude.
You get toxic fanbase that's willing to attack anyone who dares to criticize the game, no matter how valid the criticism is. Remember when Modern Warfare 2 was the peak of the series, and I'm talking about OG Modern Warfare 2, and the OGs will remember that for sure. That's when the seeds of toxicity were planted. As the game became a cultural phenomena, the more diehard fans started to see themselves as gatekeepers. If you weren't good at the game, you were trash. If you didn't buy every DLC or every skin, you weren't a real player. The elitist attitude created a hostile environment, but Activision didn't step in to stop it. And you probably would question why, because it benefited them. Over the years, as Call of Duty started to decline in quality, the fanboys got louder, of course. And instead of acknowledging the game's obvious flaws like broken mechanics, lazy map designs, and the same recycled gameplay, these fanboys would go to war for Activision, which is absolutely ridiculous.
Dude, if they just gotta fix one or two of these glitches, man!
Every time someone pointed out that Call of Duty was going downhill, they jump in with the same tired excuses. It's just beta, you're just bad at this game, or they're working on it, give them some time. Like, it's absolutely unbelievable. The palette of excuses for Activision's shady business practices is definitely off the charts by these people. This isn't just random fans defending the game. This is something that Activision actually created. They want these fanboys out there shutting down criticism because it takes the heat off them, definitely. If they can get their own community to police itself, they don't have to deal with actual issues. But it gets worse, guys. Over the past few years, there's been more and more evidence of Activision deploying an actual bot army to defend their business practices. You've seen it. Post a negative review and suddenly there are dozens of comments that all sound similar or close enough, defending Activision's latest predatory move like it's the greatest thing ever. And that just happened with Black Ops 6 beta, guys. Black Ops 6 beta was in absolute bits, and I would say the most unsuccessful beta we ever had with Call of Duty. And what they've done, they announced it as the best they ever had, which is absolute trash, garbage, and fake news.
It is what it is.
It is what it is.
When Call of Duty introduced microtransactions, remember when everyone freaked out about that? Instead of listening to the overwhelming criticism, Activision quietly let the bots and fanboys handle the dirty work. One of the most common lines you could read or hear is, "It's just cosmetics, you don't have to buy them." That's the line you'd hear over and over again. It's almost like scripted, and guess what? It probably is. Activision knows they can get away with pushing these shady business practices because they've built an echo chamber. Any legitimate concern gets drowned by fanboys and bots who attack critics and defend every move the company makes. And that leads to even more toxicity because now, not only are the games getting worse, but the community is actively hostile to anyone who tries to improve it or to suggest some improvements.
Bro, this is it, dude. I'm telling you, have you seen the trailer? Dude, this trailer's so good, dude. I swear they know what they're doing, bro. They've learned from their mistakes, bro. I'm fucking so pumped for this new COD.
Now, guys, let's talk about those shady business practices for a second. Call of Duty was once a franchise about skill and competition. Now it's a cash grab. We all know that. With every new release, Activision seems more focused on how they can squeeze every last dollar out of their players rather than delivering a quality gaming experience. $30 bundles, skins, loot boxes, battle passes, overpriced DLCs, Black Cell skins. You remember that King Kong thing for the glove you needed to pay like $80 or something, like, seriously? And yet, the fanboys defend it like their life depends on it. It's just cosmetics, they scream all the time, while ignoring the fact that the game is broken at launch, the servers are trash, and the matchmaking is rigged to keep you playing longer. Activision's goal isn't to make a good game anymore, it's to make sure you're frustrated enough to keep spending money to make the experience slightly less miserable, but remember, still miserable. This toxic cycle has been going on for years, and instead of addressing it, Activision is fueling it. The more toxic the community becomes, the more money they make because people feel like they need to spend money to stay competitive or even just to enjoy the game. And that's the latest thing that's happening with Call of Duty. If you're not paying, you're not even able to play anymore. You'll end up in shitty servers with a massive lag, like I'm having most of the time because I haven't spent anything for over a year in Call of Duty. And that's a new trend that's happening right now. They don't want you in their ecosystem if you don't pay enough. Another huge part of why Call of Duty community is so toxic is the gatekeeping. If you ever jumped in a Call of Duty lobby as a new player, you already know what I'm talking about. The community doesn't just dislike new players, they actively despise them. The insults, the trash talk, the harassment, it's all part of the Call of Duty culture now. And it's no accident. And it's done majority by the people who hardly started to play this game a year ago. Activision could have taken steps to curb this kind of behavior years ago, but they didn't. And the question is always why? Because it's part of the brand now. The toxic trash talking is what makes Call of Duty Call of Duty to a lot of people, and Activision knows that. So instead of cracking down on it, they let it fester. And then there's the gatekeeping that I already mentioned. If you're not buying every skin, if you're not grinding every day, if you're not buying the $100, $80, $30 collector's editions, you're not a real Call of Duty player. And the fanboys love to rub that in your face. Activision has built a system where people feel superior based on how much money they spend in the game, which only drives more toxic behavior. It's a never-ending cycle of elitism and harassment. And I will repeat myself when I'm talking about these things. I'm not talking about hardcore fans. I'm not talking about casual players. I'm specifically talking about the army of the newly introduced players who are nothing more but obnoxious pieces of shit that are just not having any respect toward anybody. But they are very quick to draw the guns when they need to defend Activision's shady business practices. Now let's talk about the role streamers and influencers play in all of this mess. You've got a huge names in the gaming world who are basically paid by Activision to promote Call of Duty. They are given early access, exclusive content, and all kind of perks to keep them saying positive things about the game, including the whitelists where they get easier lobbies that you will never get in this game. But they are not playing the same game you and I are. Streamers often get special treatments like whitelisting, which makes their games easier, so they can appear more skilled and entertaining to their audiences. This creates a false sense of what the game is actually like. They're promoting a version of Call of Duty that doesn't exist for the average player. And when people try to call out the bullshit, guess who shows up? The fanboys, ready to defend their favorite streamer and the game to the very death. At the end of the day, Call of Duty toxic community didn't just appear out of nowhere. It was built, nurtured, and weaponized by Activision. They've turned what once was a passionate fanbase into a toxic pool of gatekeeping, harassment, and blind loyalty. And it's all in the name of protecting their shady business practices. The fanboys are the foot soldiers or infantry, and the bots are the reinforcements, and together they've created an environment where no real criticism is allowed. The game is broken, the business practices are predatory, and yet the community defends it like it's the greatest thing gaming history ever created. If you're part of this fanbase, it's time to wake up. Activision doesn't care about you, nor will they ever care. They care about your wallet. They've manipulated you into thinking that spending money and defending the game makes you a true fan, but in reality, it just makes you part of the problem. It's time to stop blindly defending Activision and start holding them accountable. Thanks for watching, and if you're ready to demand better from Activision, hit that like button, subscribe, and let's take back gaming from the fanboys and bots who ruin it for everybody else. Let me know in the comment section below, what do you think about the topic that I just covered? Have you faced any fanboys, and how that ended? Tell me your thoughts in the comment section below, and don't forget to subscribe for future great Call of Duty content. And until next time, my fellow Verdansk citizens, I wish you all the best and stay frosty.